Security, send a detachment to the transporter room. Immediately face his side arms and be prepared to give presidential honors.
Jim, do you really believe he's Abraham Lincoln?
Well, it's obvious he believes him. Oh, Dr. McCoy, Mr. Spock, full dress uniforms.
Full dress? Presidential honors? What is all this nonsense, Mr. Dickerson?
I understand President Lincoln's coming aboard, sir.
How are you, daft man?
All I know, sir, is what the captain tells me. And he says he'll have the height of the first man that so much as smiles.
I'd have expected sanity from the ship's surgeon, at least. President Lincoln, indeed. No doubt to be followed by Louis of France and Robert the Bruce.
If so, we'll execute appropriate honors to each, Mr. Scott.
Aye, sir.
Gentlemen, I don't for a moment believe that President Lincoln is actually coming aboard, but we're dealing with an unknown and apparently highly advanced life form. Until we know, when in Rome, we'll do as the Romans do.
Bridge to transporter room. 1 minute to overhead position.
Locked onto something.
Does that appear human to you, Mr. Spock?
Fascinating. For a moment, it appeared almost mineral. Like living rock with heavy foreclaws. Settling down now to completely human readings.
We can beam it aboard any time now, sir.
Dr. McCoy, take tricorder readings and see if it is human. Appropriate ruffles and flourishes, Mr. Spock. Security, stand ready.
Phaser team, set ready for a heavy stun.
Band honor is ready, Captain.
Energize. USS Enterprise is honored to have you aboard, Mr. President.
Strange. Where are the musicians?
That's taped music, sir. A starship on active duty never carries an honor detachment.
Taped music, you say? Well, perhaps Mr. Spock will be good enough to explain that to me later. A most interesting way to come aboard, Captain. What was the device used?
An energy matter scrambler, sir. The molecules in your body are converted into energy, then beamed into this chamber and reconverted back into their original pattern.
Well, since I am obviously here and quite whole, whatever you mean apparently works very well indeed. Gentlemen, if those are weapons, please lower them. At my age, I'm afraid I'm not very dangerous.
Human, Jim.
All too human, Dr. McCoy. Happy to make your acquaintance, sir.
Mr. President, may I present my officers? Commander Spock, second in command. Engineering Officer Scott, and Security Officer Dickerson.
Mr. Spock, Mr. Scott, Mr. Dickerson. Gentlemen, I hope to talk to each of you. But meanwhile, your captain is consumed with questions, and I shall do my utmost to answer them. And I trust your duties will permit time to answer some of mine. At your service, Captain.
Lieutenant Dickerson, you and your men may return to quarters.
Mr. President.
A most interesting vessel.
Just what was it you locked onto before you beamed him aboard?
You heard Mr. Spock yourself. Mineral, he called it. Like living rock.
And that became Lincoln?
I couldn't tell. May have been another figure down there standing by. What do you make of it?
I'm not quite sure.